The atomic bomb, one of the most dangerous weapons ever created by humans. A weapon capable of killing millions, upon millions, if detonated in a city. And with the possibility of bringing on human extinction, if mass used in war. Why exactly was such a weapon created? In this first episode of the Atomic Bomb series, on the Science Channel, we will be looking into just that. The Manhattan Project. A code name for the American-led project to develop a properly working atomic bomb during the Second World War. It was started out of fears because of reports by U.S. intelligence operatives, stating that German scientists had been working on their own nuclear weapon since the 1930s, and that the genocidal Adolf Hitler was prepared to use them. The Manhattan Project was authorized by President Franklin D. Roosevelt on December 28, 1942, and was carried out under the direction of theoretical physicist J. Robert Oppenheimer, otherwise known as the rather fitting name, the father of the atomic bomb. This project engaged some of the world's leading scientific minds, and, after tons of work and experimentation, on July 16, 1945 in a remote desert location, the atomic bomb was successfully detonated, creating an enormous mushroom cloud, which rose to an incredible 40,000 feet high, thus ushering in the start of the atomic age. Now, why drop these bombs on the Japanese cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki? Well, the military leaders identified Hiroshima as the ideal target because of 1. Its size, and 2. There were no known American prisoners of war there. Dropping an atomic bomb was determined as the best and only way to make Japan surrender. On August 6, 1945, the untested little boy bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, causing unseen destruction over a 2.5-mile radius. 3 days later, with no surrender declared from Japan, the much larger Fatman atomic bomb was dropped over Nagasaki, destroying over 3 square miles of city. Combined, these two bombs killed over 100,000 people and produced such destruction never before seen, that Japan was forced to surrender. These bombings were so destructive, that even today, in 2021, their effects can still be felt. Thank you for watching this video. This was the first ever video created on the Science Channel. Please leave a like and share. Don't forget to subscribe to see our future videos where we talk about the physics and chemistry behind exactly how the atomic bomb works, what happens after a bombing, and much more.